My name is Peter Weibel. I'm a media artist since 1964. I'm a curator of the third edition. And at the moment, I'm the director of the biggest media center of the world, the Center for Art and Media Technology in Karlsruhe. I chose the subject of Sascha Walsh, that means of dance, that means of the function of the body in space and time, to give a new aspect on media use, which at the moment is a little bit out of sight. Wrongly, because media as formulated by Marshall McLuhan has been called Understanding Media 1964. The subtitle was Extensions of Man. It means extensions of body organs. The wheel is an extension of the foot, the computer an extension of the nervous system. Today, in the age of data, people don't see the relation of the data to the body. When you accumulate an enormous amount of data, the reason is that they want to find out how is the state of his health. So you must find a taxonomy to navigate you through the heap amount of data to find the right answer. And this answer is always related to the body. So media make two things. They make a new relationship between our own sensory organs, between sight and sound. Suddenly we have film. And they make also a new relationship between our organs and to our environment. So media are artificial organs, technical tools created to continue to the labor of our national organs. They can do more and in a different way. And therefore we have the Google glasses. And therefore we have even the Google lens to control our blood pressure. So you see, in fact, media have a performative use. We use them in our encounter with the environment. It's not just about arithmetics and configuration of data. And therefore it was important to remind this community, therefore the incidence on the body, on the example of Sascha Walsh. The triumph of media art today is twofolded. First, media continue to exist its own genre, always become better, so we have the classical cinematographic imaginary in video and film as images. But today, with interaction, with participation, it becomes this kind of performative bodily connection between the media. So this will continue. But the next step, the next triumph of media is that it transforms the old media too. The painters of today, like Warhol and Richter, they paint after photography. The medium of photography has become the medium of sculpture. So your land art is only documented by photography, etc., etc. So we are living now in a universal media age. We could even say in the moment when historically everything is medium, then you could even say we are living in a post-media age. But this just means we are living in a universal media age, everything is medium, and we still need media art to reform and to rewrite what we define every decade new, what is media. So the point is we will rewrite media art, but first we have to rewrite the use of media. This is, for example, the apps, applications, YouTube. These are new media tools, and it will go on like this. We always find new collective writings, new collective tools. So I would say the next step, in fact, is the most difficult with media art. The change from the classical production of art to the art of distribution. Music is already distributed. You can load it down. But art pieces are still objects. And too much of media by installations and art, etc., is too close to classical art. So what I want to look forward is the age of distribution, and even media art turns to the logic of distribution, like cinema like music that we have in future, a media cloud. This is for sure the next step. The art market, the question of the art market is precisely about distribution, because the neck of the bottle was precisely that the art market could not grasp the objects of media. And therefore we have to find a new market on the internet, an online market, and the pieces must be online. So we have to find a convergent artwork which follows the logic of distribution and a market that follows the logic of distribution. The old classical auction market will not function for media. It's a wonderful example that the most famous media artists like Nam June Paik is not on the market. And even famous artists like Bruce Norman, their sculptures, installations are on the market, but not the media work. So you see this gap. The market and the art has to follow the logic of distribution.